subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss a video from LiveLaw. Hey guys, welcome to LiveLaw. I'm Sanya in courts this week. We are in episode 22 and already in week 1 of July 2020. All right then, as usual, let's begin with the Supreme Court updates first. Supreme Court granted bail to Unitech MD and promoter Sanjay Chandra, who has been in jail for approximately 3 years. Court accepted the plea on account of both of his parents being COVID-19 positive and allowed him to be released for a period of 1 month. On earlier accounts, court had rejected Chandra's request for bail, stating that the 2017 order for deposit of ₹750 crore had not been complied with. Top court extended interim orders against coercive action and investigation granted to journalist Amish Devgan for multiple FIRs filed against him in connection with his remarks against Sufi saint Muinuddin Chisti. Senior advocate Siddharth Dutra, appearing for Devgan, informed the bench that status report regarding investigation as directed on the last date has been filed. Service on de facto complainants impleaded was granted. 1 month's time to implement grant of permanent commission and command posts for eligible women officers in Indian Navy, Army, was granted by the Supreme Court. On an application filed by the centre seeking an extension of 6 months to implement the judgment that had been delivered on 17 February 2020, directing that permanent commission should be granted to women in the Army, regardless of their service in all the 10 streams, where the Union government had already taken a decision to grant short service commission to women. Supreme Court set aside the Delhi High Court order calling for production of documents for transfer of Gautam Navlakha from Delhi to Mumbai. The direction challenged by NIA was passed by Justice Anoop Jairam Bhambani of High Court of Delhi after making an observation that the NIA had acted in unseemly haste to move Navlakha out of the jurisdiction of the Delhi court while it was considering his bail application. Supreme Court also went on to expunge the adverse remarks made against NIA by Delhi High Court. In light of difficulties faced by litigants and lawyers due to the COVID-19 pandemic towards effectuating service of summons, notices and pleadings physically through post offices, Supreme Court allowed service of summons and notices through instant telemessenger services like WhatsApp and other messenger services, as well as via email and fax. Supreme Court recalled its March 27 order allowing sale of 10% of unsold BS4 vehicles for 10 days after the lockdown and barred registration of such vehicles sold after March 31st. Following the recall of the order, the bench headed by Justice Arun Mishra held that such vehicles sold during lockdown should not be treated as sold and that the consideration received should be refunded to the purchasers. Supreme Court dismissed petition alleging adoption of a pick and choose policy by its registry and imposed a ₹100 cost on the lawyer who filed the plea. Court noted, and I quote, "In such situation, when the pandemic is going on, baseless and reckless allegations are made against the registry of this court, which is part and parcel of the judicial system. We take judicial notice of the fact that such evil is also spreading in various high courts and registry is blamed unnecessarily for no good reasons." In its suo motu writ petition pertaining to problems and miseries of migrant workers, Supreme Court pulled up state of Maharashtra for lapses in filing a detailed affidavit. Regarding the status of migrant workers in the state itself, bench stated that since the instant suo motu case was not adversarial in nature, it was a duty of the state of Maharashtra to file a detailed affidavit and apprise the court of the real-time issues faced by the migrants. Provision of Order 7 Rule 11 Code of Civil Procedure regarding rejection of plaint is mandatory in nature. Health Top Court, stating that the plaint shall be rejected if any of the grounds specified in Clause A to Clause E are made out. If the court finds that the plaintiff does not disclose a cause of action or that the suit is barred by any law, the court has no option but to reject the plaintiff. Central government told the Supreme Court that there exists no prohibition on creation of PM CARES Fund as it is independent and distinct from the National Disaster Relief Fund, which is stipulated under the Disaster Management Act 2005. Court was hearing a plea filed by Advocate Prashant Bhushan seeking transfer of funds from PM CARES to NDRF. High Courts and other court updates now. Delhi High Court refused regular bail to Sharjeel Imam and upheld the trial court order extending time for probe. Bench observed that the trial court, while granting the investigation had satisfied itself with the application of the additional public prosecutor about the reasons or grounds on which the extension of time for doing investigation was sought. Delhi University has decided to postpone examinations till August, but no specific date on which the examinations will be held was communicated before the Delhi High Court. Justice Pratibha M. Singh also directed to transfer all the petitions concerning the DU examinations before the division bench of the Delhi High Court. The Kerala High Court has observed that there are prima facie materials to show that the sister was subjected to sexual assault, including rape, by Bishop Franco Mulakal. The allegation against the bishop is that the complainant nun was subjected to rape on multiple occasions by Franco Mulakal by abusing his dominant position. After the allegation surfaced for the first time in July 2018, a collective called Save Our Sisters was launched and called for arrest of Franco. Bombay High Court issued notice to state and center in a PIL seeking special mechanism for revealing names of COVID-19 patients for the benefit of the public at large and so that one can stay away from such people and go to the doctor at the initial stage of contraction of the virus. Bench also questioned the petitioners regarding the right of privacy of such patients whose names are sought to be revealed by the petitioners. Telangana High Court dismissed PILs challenging state cabinet's decision to modify or demolish the present secretariat building in order to build a new one. The Telangana cabinet had decided to either modify or demolish the present secretariat building given its debilitated state, which has been upheld by the High Court. Suresh Swapna's anticipatory bail is not maintainable, Centre tells High Court of Kerala, in view of the fact that the NIA has taken over the probe in the Kerala gold smuggling case. Delhi High Court partially read down Delhi government's order restraining private schools from precluding students who do not pay tuition fees from attending online classes. In a plea filed by the Queen Mary School, North End, a single judge bench of Justice Jayant Nath has held that where the parents are in default for payment of tuition fees for more than 2 months, the petitioner is free to issue an appropriate notice to such parents to explain the reason for the default. Woman who lived life like a wife in the perception she was treated as a wife cannot be deprived of maintenance, held Tripura High Court. Justice S. Talapatra observed that such a woman also has a right to live in a society with dignity and that Section 125 of the CRPC must be interpreted in the light of the legislative changes which is taken into its embrace, the challenging reality of the man-woman relationship. The Court of Chief Metropolitan Magistrate Saket in Delhi has granted bail to all foreign nationals involved in tabligh activities by furnishing a bail bond of Rs 10,000 each. Thanks for watching. Hope you found this information helpful. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for similar videos. Stay safe and stay healthy. See you next week. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss a video from LiveLaw.